Here's a kind of open-ended problem involving turbines from a previous exam that has multiple correct solutions, actually. We'll just look at one interpretation that hopefully will shed light on the others. So we have a stream in this problem that starts out at 1 megapascal and 650 Kelvin. We'll treat it as an ideal gas. All right, we're going to expand this gas in one of two turbines that we'll call turbine A and turbine B. Turbine A has an efficiency of 70%, and turbine B has an efficiency of 50%. They have the same outlet temperature, so we'll call that T2. All right, and the question is, will turbine A or turbine B produce more work? All right, and so this actually can have a pretty straightforward solution, although it is initially counterintuitive. We typically assume that turbines are operated in an adiabatic fashion, and so then work will be equal to delta H. And delta H is equal to the integral from T1, which is 650K, to T2 of Cp dt. All right, that's on a per mole of ideal gas basis. All right, for both turbine A and turbine B, this integral is going to be the same because we're going between the same two temperatures, since the inlet temperature is the same and the outlet temperature is the same. All right, and therefore, the work that we get out of turbine A is equal to the work that we get out of turbine B, despite the fact that turbine A is more efficient. All right, and this actually was sufficient for answering the exam problem. All right, but the question arises, okay, how can it be that the more efficient turbine and the less efficient turbine are producing the same amount of work? All right, and that basically has to do with the fact that not all of the variables are the same in the final state. Typically, the way we work turbine problems is that if we have a reversible turbine, then for that kind of turbine, delta S reversible is equal to zero, which is equal to Cp times the log of T2 over T1 minus R log P2 over P1. This assumes that we can treat the heat capacity as constant. All right, we'll make that assumption for now. It turns out that the same arguments follow, but with more complicated math, if you can't assume that Cp is constant. This basically allows us that if we have in this problem, for example, if we have a fixed temperature difference, that's not normally how we talk about turbine problems, is we usually refer to how much of an expansion they give us, so what the pressure difference is. All right, but in this case, we're saying that the temperature change is going to be the same for these turbines. All right, so T2 over T1 is some fixed quantity. All right, and so now we'll look instead at what happens to the pressure. All right, and so for this T2 over T1, we can change we can calculate for a reversible turbine what P2 over P1 will be. As the efficiency goes down from 100%, so for a reversible turbine, the efficiency would be 100%. All right, as that efficiency goes down, based on this relationship that's shown here, if we're holding T2 over T1 fixed, as we are in this problem, then as the efficiency goes down, delta S goes up. All right, and for delta S to go up with T2 over T1 being held fixed, as it is in this problem, then therefore P2 over P1 has to go down. And since P1 is fixed at 1 megapascal in this problem, this means that as the efficiency goes down and the entropy goes up, therefore the final pressure goes down. All right, and so in other words, turbine B, to get that same final temperature as we have for turbine A, that the final pressure, we have to have done more of an expansion. All right, so we have to have lost more of an opportunity to do work by decreasing our pressure by a larger amount for turbine B. And so therefore, the outlet pressure in turbine B is going to be less than the outlet pressure for turbine A.